I wasn't sure we were going to have a spring sports season this year with the way it started out, the number of cancellations and changes that had to be made. And I was joking with Mr. Held earlier on in the season that we might end up having to cancel the whole season just because of weather. But we're here, we made it through the season, and I appreciate y'all coming. Thank you all for coming to the Spring Sports Awards night. I'm honored to be able to begin this evening by recognizing our scholar athletes. As you all know here tonight, there are great demands placed on our students, our student athletes, both during competition and during the school day. It is my pleasure to recognize this year's Spring Scholar athletes who have not only met the requirements set forth by their coaches, but have also excelled in the classroom. Athletes, please stand as we recognize this year's scholar athletes. Please hold your applause until everyone from that sport is standing. Start with boys track. Jason Bixler, all A's. Luke Green, all A's. Alex Gudeman, all A's. Patrick Kays, all A's. Wesley Meyer, all A's. Nathan Holloway, all A's. Eli Pugh, all A's. Sam Adams, Josh Baker, Matt Basham, Dale Beck, Willie Brown, Cameron Bucknow, Brad Birch, Austin Calvert, Tanner Campbell, Noah Dahlquist, Connor McLaughlin, Braxton Molden, Nick Neust, Tanner Powell, Tyler Powell, Brody Schaefer, Dale Shelburne, Deshaun Whitfield, and Michael Whitfield. The girls' track, Anna Barris, all A's, Sarah Birch, all A's, Saray Carpenter, all A's, Shauna Ellinger, all A's, Michelle Henning, all A's, Jody Jones, all A's, Anna Meyer, all A's, Sammy Rupert, all A's, Caitlin Sawyer, all A's, Katie Schaller, all A's, Emily Shepherd, all A's, Morgan Tyler, all A's, Allison Webb, all A's, Ellie Barris, Ivy Brock, Tracy Birch, Alyssa Clevenger, Emily King, Nicole Ranstead, Callie Richard, Chloe Richard, Lara Santos, Zoe Setzer, Anna Schaefer, Jordan Sheets, and Kaylee Stone. For baseball, Jacob Houdeshell, all A's. Levi Brown, all A's. Frank Etchison, all A's. Cyrus Holland, all A's. Randall Black, all A's. Alec Holland, Andrew Feldman, Hayden Shalley, Carter Streeton, Brett Abbott, Tanner Hampton, Wes Gong, Michael Kistler, Dominic Thomas, Tanner Music, Brendan Fansler, AJ Knox. For softball, Keaton Stasiak, all A's. Maggie Good, all A's. Alexa Holland, all A's. Lexi Holland, all A's. Libby Good, all A's. Jessica Dalton, all A's. Taryn Stockberger, all A's. McKenna Morgan, Riley Holland, Bailey Abbott, Becky Malko, Carly Murphy, Kayla Smith, Aaron Johnson, and Michaela Rubin. The girls tennis, Caitlin Bucknow, all A's. Brooke Ewing, all A's. Audrey Franklin, all A's. Caitlin Patterson, all A's. Adrian Pollock, all A's. Maddie Lewis, Elena Franklin, Shaylee Kelly, Mariah LaChance, Carol Morris, and Britton Walker. And for boys golf, John Odell, Landon Knotts, Kennedy, Noah Roberts, Marcus Smiley, Daniel Butler, and Travis Harrell. Next, we would like to recognize the Academic All-TRC Award winners. The Academic All-Conference team was a pilot program began by the conference athletic directors in 2002. Recently, the program was modified to honor any athlete in an IHSAA sport who met the following criteria. He or she is a junior or a senior, has a minimum of a 3.4 GPA on a 4-point scale, and a class rank in the top 30% for honorable mention, or has a minimum of a 3.8 GPA and a class rank in the top 15% for the first team all TRC academic honors. This spring's academic all-conference honorable mention winners are, we'll go by sports, and athletes, please come up and receive your certificates at this time. For boys track, Alex Gudeman. Austin Calvert, Matt Basham, and Tucker Campbell. Baseball's All-Conference Honorable Mention winner, Levi Brown. Girls tennis, Maddie Lewis. Girls track, Academic All-Conference Honorable Mention winner, Ivy Rock. Rounding out the Academic All-Conference Honorable Mention winners for softball, Riley Holland and Kaylee Smith. This spring's Academic All-Conference first team medallion recipients for boys track, Lucas Green and Brad Birch. Softball, Academic All-Conference First Team Medallion recipients, Maggie Good and Carly Murphy. Academic All-Conference First Team Medallion recipients for girls tennis, Aubrey Franklin and Caitlin Patterson. Academic All-Conference First Team Medallion recipients for girls track, Anna Meyer. Allison Webb. Caitlin Sawyer. Emily Shepard. Shauna Ellinger. Baseball, Cyrus Holland. Brant Etchison. And Carter Street. Congratulations, athletes. You truly represent Rochester very well. Seniors, I wish you the best of luck. Obviously, we've still got graduation coming up, so we'll all be talking to you then. I want to thank all the coaches and parents for supporting and helping your athlete not only excel in the chosen sport, but also excel in the classroom. Enjoy your evening. Good luck to those that are still competing. Go Z's.
One of the most rewarding things in my job is that I get to share in all the successes that our students have. And we have a lot of success here, and kids have made us very proud. But nights like this also give me a lot of trepidation, because I think about all the people I'm likely to forget, and how the moment I walk out of here, I'm going to be kicking myself for forgetting to mention someone who is important. So I want to start off tonight by mentioning two very important people, and calling at least one of them to the stage, Christina Hughes. It's Sue Cash, but Sue can't be with us tonight, but I'll say a few words about her as well. Tonight, Christina and Mrs. Cash are receiving plaques. They read, in recognition of years of dedicated service to the student athletes of Rochester High School, and they're dated for today. For those of you who don't know, Christina has taken a promotion and will now be the boss of the person who fills her shoes, if anyone can ever fill her shoes. She served us for nearly a decade. When she came to town, her children were unborn. On the way, but unborn. She's been with us that entire time, served thousands of athletes, seen countless injuries, ones that make me squeamish. She doesn't bat an eye. She's done a great job with our kids, and we will truly miss her, but I'm glad that she's still going to be with us in that advisory capacity. Thank you very much, Christina. The numbers of hours Christina's put in are truly immeasurable. They blow my mind. I know I'm here a lot of hours, and Christina probably is one up on me. Mrs. Cash will not be leaving the corporation, but she will be taking a different position at the middle school. Mrs. Cash has been the secretary for Rochester High School for a dozen years. She's been at the high school for nearly 25 years, and we're glad that she's still here, and I'm glad that she stuck around for a year to make sure that I got on my 2 feet, and I'll miss her very much, and she probably deserves a standing ovation as well.
Yeah.
Wherever I go, I make my first big error. She definitely deserves a standing ovation. I'm glad she's going to see this on RTC. Also, I do want to thank Chris Messersmith back there. He did put together this collage on the last minute. I got a call at about 12:30 today with the idea of putting this on. Dee Brown came up with the idea and Chris executed it, so thanks to RTC for that. Spring sports are a really strange time because basically our athletes are still participating at the time the awards occur. So I do want to acknowledge that our golf team is still participating. They'll be at sectional play on June 31st at the Logan Sport. No, it is May 31st at Logan Sport at Dykeman Golf Course. That's not this Friday, but the next one. No, it's this Friday. Number two. Also, we have a few track athletes still participating. Cameron Bugno will participate in the state finals of pole vault. That is this Friday at IU at 3 o'clock. We wish Cameron the best of success and congratulate him for reaching the state level. And also, Caitlin Sawyer will compete the next day in long jump, same time, 3 o'clock at IU, and very proud of her as well. She is a regional champion. At this time, I'd also like to recognize some team accomplishments. You'll see three trophies located in the middle of the awards table. The one on your right is the softball team. They won the TRC title this year, going undefeated. The one on your left is the girls' track team, who won their first ever TRC title this year. And the one in the center is kind of the culmination of those two. That's the all-TRC sports award. The way they figured this award is for each sport that we compete in, you're given a percentage. If you take first place in your sport, you get 100%, and you average out all your percentages. The girls' rating was 91.7. The next closest school was Southwood with a 64.9. The girls were bolstered by titles in track, softball, cross country, and golf. They also took second in volleyball and tennis and tied for third in basketball. A very competitive group. The boys finished second in the all-TRC standings. They were narrowly edged out by Northfield. The score was 72.3 to 72.1. Just 0.2 of a percentage separating first and second place. We did have first place finishes in the TRC in cross country, football, wrestling, and a second place finish in track, and a third place in basketball. So very successful team performances for both our boys and our girls. Some individual spring accomplishments to recognize. The first person I want to talk about is Anna Meyer. She's a sectional champ in the 1600, the 3200. She set TRC meet records this year in the 800 at 222.98. She also owns the school's 800 record. She also set a TRC meet record in the 1600 at 5:15.20. Prior to the season, Meyer also broke the 3200 meter run record and is a member of the 4x4 record team and the 4x8 record team. It'll be a long time before we see the likes of someone like Anna again. Another athlete with some exceptional performances this year, Caitlin Sawyer, sectional, regional, and TRC champ in the long jump, TRC champ in the 400, school record holder in the long jump with a leap of 17 feet 6 inches. She's also a member of school record holding 4x1 and 4x4 teams. Shauna Ellinger was TRC champ this year in shot put. Very proud of her, particularly because she missed all of last year with injury and came back and won the championship this year. Jordan Sheets, TRC pole vault champion. She was the champion heading into this year and defended it successfully this year. Alex Gudeman, sectional champ in the 1600. Ramson Bednimrod, TRC champ in the 110 high hurdles. The girls 4x8 team broke a school record, 10:11.5. Katie Camp, Sarah Burge, Sammy Rupert, and Anna Meyer, members of that team. Boys 4x8 team were sectional champs of Brandon Camp, Wes Meyer, Jeff Farrell, and Alex Gudeman. The 4x8 team also won the TRC, a slightly different lineup. Brandon Camp, Nick Scheidler, Jeff Farrell, and Alex Gudeman. We'll recognize Luke Kennedy, who was third in the TRC in golf. And Riley Holland and Maggie Good, I'd like to give them special recognition for both being selected to the North-South All-Star team.
The next five individuals I want to talk about have already been recognized by the TRC, but I'd like to call them on stage and have them recognized in front of Rochester High School. Those people are Lauren Doherty, Caitlin Sawyer, Anna Meyer, Maggie Good, and Brad Birch. I'll allow them to stand up here awkwardly as I describe their accomplishments. They were selected to attend the TRC Mental Attitude Banquet. And to attend this banquet, you had to be nominated by a coach and meet a pretty rigorous criteria. You had to be a senior on the varsity squad. You had to be nominated by the coach, the AD, or principal. You had to excel in mental attitude, athletic ability, scholarship, and leadership for 4 years. And you had to meet minimum requirements of 1,500 on the SAT or 21 on the ACT and rank in the top 15% in your class. We had other students who were nominated, but these were students who were selected. Lauren Doherty is the TRC Mental Attitude Award winner in golf. Caitlin Sawyer won the TRC Mental Attitude in volleyball and was nominated as well in track. Anna Meyer won two TRC Mental Attitudes. She won in cross country and track. Maggie Good is the TRC Mental Attitude Award winner in softball. Brad Birch won another honor, this Distinguished Academic Athlete Award. To meet that, you had to be nominated 5 out of your 6 eligible seasons, and Brad received 5 nominations. Lauren Doherty and Anna Meyer also earned the Scholar Athlete Award, which is new to the TRC this year. Very high academic standards are necessary to attain this. You have to score an 1850 or higher on the SAT, or a 27 or higher on the ACT. You have to be in the top 5% of your graduating class, and you have to have been nominated for the TRC Mental Attitude Award. This is an exceptional group of kids. We were the best represented group in the TRC, and I'm very proud of these 5 individuals. The next award is one we give out only in the spring. It's the Blanket Award. The Blanket Award at Rochester High School is earned by accumulating 60 or more points during a high school athletic career. An athlete earns 7 points for each varsity letter one, 5 points for a season as a varsity manager, 3 points for freshman or junior varsity participation, and 2 points for seasons as statisticians or other support groups such as matinees. In almost every case, a young man or young lady must be involved year-round as an athlete to obtain this award. In addition to the 60 points, an athlete must exhibit good citizenship and behavior through graduation. Each Blanket Award winner also must defend all letters earned in their junior year. So if an athlete earns an award in their junior year and does not come back their senior year in that sport, they become ineligible for this award. In the class of 2013, more than 95 students competed during the 4 years they were in school. Only 4 of these athletes met the criteria to win the award. Our Blanket Award winners this year are Caitlin Sawyer, who participated in 10 seasons, earned 4 varsity letters in volleyball, 2 in swimming, and 4 in track, and accumulated 70 points. Our second winner is Callie Richard. Callie participated in 9 seasons, earning 3 varsity letters in soccer, 2 in swimming, and 4 in track, and accumulated 66 points to earn the blanket. Riley Holland is our third winner. Riley participated in 10 seasons, earning 1 varsity letter in volleyball, 4 in basketball, and 4 in softball. She accumulated 66 points toward earning her blanket. Jeff Farrell is our sole male winner. Jeff participated in 9 seasons, earning 4 varsity letters in cross country, 2 in swimming, and 4 in track. He accumulated 63 points toward the blanket. This time we'll move into the major awards for each sport before we break off. The awards will go through our team captains, most promising athlete, most approved athlete, mental attitude award winner, and most valuable athlete. Prior to the giving of each award, I'll read a description, and then coaches will come up and talk about the athletes who were selected for those awards. The order will go in our track and field with Coach Stahlbaum, baseball with Coach Hooker, boys golf with Coach Hoffman and Coach Lingenfelter, girls tennis with Coach Hooker, and softball with Coach Hoffman. First award tonight is team captains. Leadership is often the intangible that is missing from those teams who never seem to fulfill their potential. At the same time, it's often very evident on those teams who rise to championship levels. Team captains must serve as leaders, as recruiters, as assistant coaches with younger players, and as positive role models for all team members.
When I took over for Coach Help this year, when he moved to the AD position, I guess I wasn't sure how much work it was going to be, and it ended up being a lot harder than I thought it was going to be, and a lot more hours. So when the maturity that these four showed during practice and the meets really helped out a lot and really helped our team be successful this year. Some of them are leaders on the track, and some of them are leaders off the track. They both have their strengths, and they work really well together to help kind of push this team forward. Anna Meyer, Shauna Ellinger, Brad Birch, and Nick Neust.
Mr. Hell said, sometimes there's different protocol for when your captains step to the plate. Sometimes they are there at the start of the season. Other times they just simply emerge, and at a very critical time in our baseball season, these people rose up and took control of the baseball team. The good news is that all three of them will be back next year to lead us. Our three captains, juniors, Cyrus Holland, Tanner Hampton, and Carter Screeden.
Boys golf team captain did set the tone for practice on a regular basis. I can say he was fully committed to following Monty and I's instructions for practice, which is very difficult when you've got a lot of guys who would like to go play golf and you know they really need to go hit about 250 golf balls a night. So he was very committed to that, and you know that's easy to do when you're playing well. It's easy to do when everything's going your way, but when your game starts to struggle a little bit and maybe it's not what you hoped it would be, to stick with the program and keep doing the things that you know you should do through that time. He did that. Matter of fact, he got taken out of a couple of matches and didn't get to participate at the varsity level. He missed a home invitational, which probably would have been a nice place to shoot a good score due to a sister's wedding, I believe. And he just stuck with it the whole year. I think he has probably the most technically efficient golf swing we've got on the team. And I think he'll end up being a very, very good golfer in the years to come if he can manage to skip a few classes at Purdue and head to the golf course. So I hope that's the case, and our team captain is Chris Hoffman.
Each spring as we start our season, the girls on the team vote for their captains. And with six great seniors on the squad this year to choose from, we knew that any of the choices were going to be great. I really can't speak any higher of the senior class of girls. The 3 or 4 years that you gave to the RHS tennis have been awesome and done a lot of accomplishments here. So all six of you are going to be missed an awful lot. But our captains this year were Adrian Pollock and Brooke Ewing.
Thank you. both our captains are known to be perfectionists. They lead by example. They have good work ethics. And this winning attitude produced 99 wins, first ever LaPorte Tourney championship, 3 conference championships, 1 sectional win, 1 regional win during their entire high school career. Our captains, Maggie Good and Riley Holland.
Our next award is for the most promising athlete. It's important that coaches continue to work hard to recruit the best possible athletes for his or her sport. It's especially gratifying when a coach gets a young man or young lady in their freshman or sophomore year that shows talent, potential, determination, and a positive attitude to be a real champion in their high school career. Hopefully the award earned tonight as most promising will serve to encourage each of these athletes on to bigger and better seasons in their RHS careers.
This person for girls most promising was somebody that at the beginning of the year, as the coaches were kind of sitting around a table trying to figure out who's going to be in what events, we were like, well, we got to get her into some event. She needs to go somewhere. She needs to get in the meet. And then by halfway through the season, the conversation turned to, man, I wish we could get her in more events. At the beginning of the season, we didn't know how fast she was, but it turns out she was really fast. Hannah Schaefer. On the boys' side, distance running is something that is very strong here at Rochester, and as a freshman, this boy came in and was one of our top distance runners from the very beginning, despite a lot of upperclassmen that I thought might be ahead of him. He ran 4:36 for the mile, which, if you guys don't know how fast that is, it's really, really fast, especially for a freshman. Actually, he's like 1 second away from my PR, and I used to think I was good, but maybe not, I don't know. He's gonna be a star in the next few years. Wesley Meyer.
For the baseball team, we were about one-third of the way through the season, and we were trying to find some pieces that would fit into our lineup. Thinking about moving some people around, and I remember a specific conversation with Coach Stasiak. We didn't know quite what to do, and we just said, hey, let's just do this. Let's get this guy up here, and let's keep him here and see what happens. And as it turned out, it was a great idea. More Coach Stasiak talking me into it. I was a little nervous about it, but as it turned out, it was a great, great move. Without question, this young man had just a phenomenal season, off the charts, more than what we could ever expect. A lot of baseball to come. Our most promising is freshman Alec Holland.
This year to have several young golfers who participated on the team quite a bit. We've got a bright future, a lot of young kids that are working really hard on their game, but this young man played in all but one of our varsity events this year. He was never our lowest scorer in the event, but he had the lowest average, the second lowest average of all of our golfers this year. He's got a bright future. We look forward to him, and I think he found out tonight that he needs to pick me to be on his golf team. Aaron Orr.
Did I have 6 wonderful seniors on the varsity? round that off with our seventh player with B. Shelby, but I also had some fabulous JV players that could step up at a moment's notice and play some varsity. Many JV players gave the varsity players some challenging matches at practice. But one young lady is putting some time into changing her shots to include lots of topspin and much more placement. So our most promising player we look forward to see play next year, it is Elena Franklin.
On the bases, was an offensive threat, and played a great middle infield defense. The nice thing about this year's most promising is that there are two of them, and Rochester has them for three more years. It's Alexa Holland and Becky Malco.
Our next award is for our most improved athlete. One of the goals for every sports program is to continue to strive for improvement, whether that means a better time, a 3,200 meter run, a higher batting average, or fewer putts per round. Improvement is often the key to many of the successes of our athletic programs.
Once again, with the most improved, beginning of the year, a coach is sitting at the table again. And we're talking about what is this person going to contribute for the track team on the field, or on the track. And we couldn't really figure it out at the beginning of the year, but when the first meet rolled around, we sure knew that he wasn't the same person he was as a junior. He was a lot faster. His attitude was better. Everything was better. Our most improved boy is Nick Neust. Our most improved girl started the season. She was throwing okay at the beginning, but she was throwing really great at the end. In the shot put, she ended up throwing 6 feet farther at the end of the year than she did at the beginning of the year. Argumentatively, she could have been in the running for the most promising as well, because she's also a freshman, Saray Carpenter.
Baseball, this young man has made some dramatic improvement since he's been at Rochester High School, and I think he knows and I know that the bar can even be set a lot higher. There are times during games where I see in his eyes that he knows he can give even more than what he's giving. His performance can improve much more. I think the potential for that is there. He's not getting the award because of that. But I think the top level for this person is much higher. Has 1 year to do that. And I believe that'll be accomplished. Don't want to give this award necessarily to him next year, but our most improved player, Cyrus Holland.
Several that unfortunately I didn't see much last summer. I was kind of hoping the golfers would show up around the course, but I missed a few of them last summer. So consequently, I didn't really know what to expect from him. Truthfully, I didn't expect a whole lot. He doesn't have the best golf swing on the team. He's probably not the best chipper. He's not the best putter. But you know, he pays a lot of attention to detail. And you can see when he's hitting shots and when he's warming up and when he's getting ready to play. He is focused on what he's doing, and he gets the most, I think, out of his talent and ability level. So consequently, after play this year, I think he was low for us in three matches after not being a varsity member last year. So now I really don't know what to expect from him next year either, but our most improved player this year is Alex Denny.
Players that start their freshman year, you're realizing that they love this sport of tennis. Nor do I usually have players that play on the off season so regularly in the summer and spend many, many hours a week throughout the winter on an indoor court. Shelby, your work has paid off. Your improvements have definitely led you to a successful sophomore year at number two singles. What an accomplishment and what great improvements in your game. Ms. Shelby Banks.
This year, as coaches, we're kind of standing around looking at the talent that we have, and we knew that we needed to find a pitcher. It's very crucial with softball, and we were terrified by thinking about how long our season just might be. But we found it a pleasant surprise. This player worked hard in the offseason, worked hard, you know, once our season did start, found a pitching coach. And she led our team to a 22-3 record as a freshman. And we look forward to see what she will produce for us in the years to come. Lexi Howland.
Our next award is the Mental Attitude Award. The coach's favorite person may be a unique way to describe this award, but in many ways it's true. The question that needs to be asked is, why is this person the coach's favorite? The answer will be because he or she always listens and tries to do what's right, always hustles during all practices as well as in contests, always tries to provide leadership and be a positive example for the underclassmen of the program. Talent and potential are not qualities needed for the Mental Attitude Award winner, and never say die attitude coupled with a positive outlook on life are the qualities of a mental attitude award winner.
I've rarely heard Coach Reeves talk as highly as she does about this person. She works really, really hard every practice. She's got a great attitude, great work ethic, and she's one of the most mature people I know. She definitely deserves this award, and that's Jordan Sheets. This next one is a little bit more personal for me because this is somebody that I was really worried about for a while. I'm really, really happy this person kind of got their life back together and got things on the right track. I would have never guessed that I would ever give this award to him, but he definitely has earned it, and his attitude in general is just amazing this year, and everybody sees it, and that's Brandon Camp.
Handed knucklehead of the year trophy.
uh,
I mean, that's a compliment. He's come a long way. It's great to see. Mental attitude for baseball. Everything that Mr. Health said cannot be said any stronger for this young man. You know where you stand every single day in practice. Every single time that you see him, what you see is what you get. It's like having another coach on the field. The value of that person to any kind of organization just can't be measured. The Mental Attitude Award goes to Carter Screeden.
About one young man who did not get the Mental Attitude Award. Monty and I kind of threw out our names and we bargained a little bit, lobbied, and before we decided on who we were going to go with. But this young man is a freshman that didn't win. He had a concussion from football in the fall. He came to practice and found out through doctor's orders and IHSAA and insurance guidelines and regulations that there were a lot of things we were going to do in practice that he couldn't take part in. So consequently, he came every night, night after night, with no hope of ever playing because he couldn't get into a match or an invitational because of the status of his concussion. And so he came and practiced chipping and putting, chipping and putting, chipping and putting, night after night after night. And just stayed committed to it. And we were kind of laughing before we teed off tonight in a little scramble that we had about how Travis is likely going to be the best chipper and putter around, but I would like to thank Travis Harrell for sticking with us on that. And then our Mental Attitude Award winner is actually somebody that when I heard he was coming out for golf this year, I didn't know him, and I kind of thought, you know, he's a senior, he's gonna come out for golf, and he's never played on the golf team before, and he's really just maybe looking for something to goof around with, and that's really not what we need. We need to work on our games a little bit, so I thought this probably wouldn't be good if we had somebody who was a little on the silly side of practice. And I couldn't have been more wrong at all. He is extremely competitive. He has a desire to improve and a work ethic that really showed all season. He started out score-wise very badly. He worked through, we had multiple qualifiers throughout the year where he was a shot, two shots off of getting into varsity matches and invitationals all year. But he really demonstrated his inner character, and he came to practice every night with an excitement and a desire to get better and really improve. And he stayed after practice and he asked questions. And Monty and I got more texts from him than anybody around on what he was doing and what he was gonna shoot and how he was gonna get there. And I don't have any doubt that if we had a second half to this season that he would be a varsity member. So I want to thank John O'Dell for being a great example for all of you.
What a privilege it has been to have worked with this young lady for 4 years. I've seen her grow into a beautiful young woman, positive to all, encouraging others at times when they needed it most, when we're conditioning, when freshmen are new to the courts. She's dug herself out of several tough matches to win after a set that she had just lost and had been playing very poorly. She has worked hard to become a valuable tennis player. And I definitely foresee her working just as hard next year at college. Caitlin Bugnell.
Thank
our mental attitude award winner always puts 110% in every practice, whether she was playing or not playing, was the first to shag balls, just wore a smile on her face all the time, always asked, what can I do to get better? Not, you know, when can I play? It's a coach's dream of always wanting a player to get better and get better and work at it. Her hard work paid off because she did earn a starting position in postseason. It's Bailey Abbott.
Our final award tonight is the most valuable athlete. The person who means the most to the team is a good way to describe the most valuable athlete. The most valuable athlete is not necessarily the most talented, but is the player who contributes the most to the program. The most valuable athlete must provide leadership and also exhibit outstanding skill in the sport. I believe the one way to determine who the most valuable athlete is simply to ask the question, where would this team have been without this person?
For track, we actually give a most valuable field event and a most valuable runner or track athlete for each one. So for the girls' side on the most valuable field event, we actually had two. Both girls did an amazing job this year scoring a ton of points for us and were huge in us winning our first TRC title ever. One went to state, and that would be Caitlin Sawyer. And the other one, I think she only lost shot put once all year until sectionals. So she was almost undefeated in the shot put on the year. She did really great. So that's Shauna Ellinger and Caitlin Sawyer. Most valuable field event on the boys' side. Over the last couple of years, I've really enjoyed watching this person high jump. I find myself envious, wishing that I could jump like that. I think most people do. He jumped 6'7" last year, was the sectional champion. He jumped 6'4" this year and was in second place in the sectional. He's going to have a great college career if he chooses to do so. He's going to Manchester next year, and I really do hope he competes in track. Ramson Betnemerov. Our most valuable distance girl, Mr. Held just at the beginning of this kind of mentioned all of her accolades over the last few years. But the most important one, I think, is that she now owns four records over in the record board, above the concession stand out there. And it's not very often that a coach gets to coach somebody who has that many records and is that successful, is that dedicated, runs that many miles, works that hard, and that's Anna Meyer. Our most valuable runner on the boys' side, just this last Thursday at regionals, he was 1 second away from making it to state, and it was about the hardest thing I've ever seen. He's the hardest worker I've ever known. He's somebody that I think you would have never thought would have been as good as he's become this last year, especially, but he's probably been my favorite person I've ever coached because he's the hardest worker and he's just I think he will put himself through more pain in a race than anybody I've ever seen. And that's Alex Goodman.
Player for baseball. This young man has devoted just an incredible amount of time to this sport throughout his lifetime. what Mr. Hell says about where would the team be without him, that really hits it on the head. Every day, every practice, every minute, this person is all baseball, and every phase of the game, very hard worker. Even over the last year or so, you even see him kind of laugh and smile a little bit. Got to get him out of the serious mode every now and then. But our most valuable player is Tanner Hampton.
Lyle and I talked a lot at the beginning of the season, and we expected a lot out of this young man, and he didn't disappoint us. I can tell how he's playing from a half a course away by his body language. He's never happy with the shot he hits. He always wants to be better. He's always working hard on the range, and it's started to pay off. He's played every varsity match for us. He shot his lowest score a couple weeks ago at TRC to make all conference. Very happy for this young man. Our MVP is Luke Kennedy.
Our most valuable player is a senior with 4 years' experience on our team. She's played a position that needs dedication to the sport. It needs mental as well as physical toughness and strength. And this number one singles position is always guaranteed a tough match no matter who we are playing against. So our number one singles player and voted MVP is Maddie Lewis.
We have two MVPs this year. These two young ladies had a great high school career. And if you've ever been to watch us play, you'll know how exciting it is to watch these two young ladies play ball. They have two different styles. They're two different styles of players. One's a slapper, one's a power hitter. They complement each other very well. They've had a lot of success. They've impacted our program tremendously. In 4 years, helping the younger players out just by their example. Maggie Good was named second team All-State, and Riley was named third team All-State. We've only had three players in history to be named All-State. Both will, like Ryan had said earlier, both will represent RHS at the Indiana All-Star Game. And both will continue their softball career at the collegiate level. Maggie Good will attend IUPUI, and Riley Holland will play softball at Indiana State.
I have many people to thank tonight, but rather than take up a lot of your time with thank yous, I included an insert in tonight's program. Any omissions are completely accidental. I know with the number of people we have helped, people always get overlooked, and it's certainly not intentional, but I am human, believe it or not. But a special thank you to the administration at RHS and the corporation office. Another thank you to Christina Hughes, who's been a tremendous asset to me. Sue Cash has been invaluable. I also want to thank Bob Reed and Brian Stockberger, who had a heck of a job, and Jim Swank as well, who had a heck of a job getting our fields in order with all the rain that we had at the beginning of the spring. They really worked as hard as you can imagine to make sure that we got as many games in as we could. Also want to thank Scott Kistler, who worked behind the scenes on almost everything. Scott works in the tech department, but he might as well work for athletics as well. Our coaching staffs have been incredible this year. I want to thank Brian Hooker, Keith Kozier, Tony Stasiak, Eric Surface, and Jim Yoakum, Monty Hoffman and Lyle Lingenfelter, Tandy Hooker and Jesse Atkinson, Carla Holland, Brad Good, Andy Holland, Tom Smith, Scott Stallbaum, Carmen Reeves, Kim Hughes, and Brad Weaver. I want to thank parents for their support and encouragement, the sportsmanship that they've shown at our contests, and their loyalty to RHS. Also want to thank the Sentinel, WRY, Channel 4, and Rochester Telephone Company. And most of all, I want to thank our athletes. When our athletes are good kids of high caliber character, they make everyone's job easy. You just put them in positions to perform, and our kids have really done that across our programs. Also to athletes, I'd send this message. If you didn't reach your goals this year, there are always new goals to be set and met. Set your goals high and be willing to work hard to achieve them. At this time, we're going to break up into individual sports for additional awards. Baseball will meet in the auxiliary gym, and I apologize already for the heat. I have no control over it. Track will remain in the auditorium. Golf will head to the library. Tennis in the main gym, and softball in the cafeteria. Also, want to remind award winners that following your breakout sessions here, Mike Kenny from the Sentinel will be here to take your pictures, so you'll meet at Zebby. Thank everyone so much for making this a great year, not just for RHS, but for me. Makes me feel welcome here in my first year, and making my job great. Thank you, and have a great night.